Piano play it.
Boo-boo-boo-boo.com.
Hi, welcome back to another free piano lesson by pianoplay.com. This is David here, and today we're going to review the dotted notes. So, until today we learned about the dotted whole note, the dotted half note, and today we're going to review these dotted notes, and we're going to add the dotted quarter note, the dotted eighth note. So let's start. So in the previous lessons we've learned that when we add a dot after a note, we add half as much again to the basic note duration. So let's take the whole note for example. A whole note is worth 4 beats. We add a dot after the note and we have to add 2 more beats because half of 4 is 2. 4 plus 2 is 6. So a dotted whole note is worth 6 beats. Now let's take a dotted half note. A half note is worth 2 beats. Half of 2 is 1. So when we add a dot after a half note, we get 3 beats. 2 plus 1. So, as you can see, we can write it also as a half note attached with a slur to a quarter note. Now, what do we do with the dotted quarter note? It's basically the same. A quarter note is worth 2 eighth notes. So, when you add a dot after a quarter note, you have to add an eighth note, an extra eighth note. 2 eighth note plus an eighth note, we have 3 eighth notes. Now you remember that when we have 8 notes we count 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and a dotted quarter note is worth 3 eighths. You count 1 and 2 and you enter in the end. Mostly you enter with an extra 8th note. Okay, so Alouette for example has a dotted quarter note. When we have a dotted quarter note we count 1 and 2 and. The dotted note gets the 1 and 2, and in the end we have to add an extra 8th note. Let's see, for example, Alouette starts with middle C. 1 and 2, D, E, E. Why? Because the C is a dotted quarter note, so 1 and 2, D is the extra 8th note. 1 and 2, and 3 and 4, and. Okay, the E are both a quarter note, why do I still count 3 and 4 and? That's because in pieces with 8th notes I always go according to the shortest rhythmic measure, so 8th notes in this case, in order to keep the rhythmic feeling consistent. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Again a dotted quarter note. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay, the last part of our lesson is adding the dotted eighth note. Now we have to realize when we add a dot after an eighth note, what is an eighth note made of? An eighth note is made of 2 sixteenth notes. If you are not sure why an eighth note has 2 sixteenth notes, just visit my sixteenth notes lesson before you preview this lesson, okay? And come back here. So an eighth note has 2 sixteenth notes, so by adding a dot after the eighth note, we have to add an extra 16th note. So 2 16th notes plus an extra 16th note, we have 3 16th notes. We have to add another 16th note in order to get a whole quarter note. So let's see how we do it. When we count 16th notes, we count 1 and da. Remember from the 16th notes lesson? So 3 16th notes are worth 1 and. And in the A, we have to add an extra 16th note. So, 1 and A, 2 and A, 3 and A. The A is the extra 16th note. You know what? Let's add a pitch with a dotted 16th note to be sure. Okay, so I'm gonna put this piano lesson in here, but if you want to learn about the dotted 8th note, what you have to do is click on the link on the right or below, depends on where you're watching, and there it will direct you to the specific page where I show the full piano lesson with piano pieces with a dotted eighth note, and I demonstrated the full piano lesson how to play a piece with a dotted quarter note and a dotted eighth note. So I'll see you over there, okay? Until the next piano lesson, bye guys!
Piano play it! Piano play it. .com